Hello students, how are you all? Hope you all are enjoying your holidays and my classes as well. Bete, till now we have discussed about creating 1D array and 2D array. Today we will discuss about accessing elements of an array. So let us start the topic. But in the first video I told you that an array have two things. First is the element and second one is the index. So you know that elements are the values stored in the array, but what about index? Today we will discuss about indexing. So when we are talking about array indexing, so we can access an array element by referring to its index number. Okay, suppose in case bete we don't want the whole array as the output, we want to access any particular element, then in that case the index value will be needed. Okay, so the indexes in NumPy array starts with 0, meaning that the first element has index 0. When we are talking about index, index means the position where the array elements are stored, and the position of the very first element starts from 0. Remember bete, this is a very important thing. The position of the first element will always be 0 if we are moving from left side to the right side. Okay, so if we are accessing the elements from left to right side of the array, then the position of the first element will be 0 and the second element will be 1, and like that. Suppose we are having 9 elements, then the position will be from 0 to 8. So indexing will be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay. Now, array elements may have also negative indexing. Negative indexing means negative indexing can also be used to access array element, but this time the element will be traversed from the end. Previously we were traversing the element from beginning to the end. This time the starting point will be from end. So the traversing will be from right side to left side. So if anywhere you are getting negative index value, then you get the conclusion that the movement, the traversal should be from right side to the left side. So if we have to traverse from right side to left side, then index will be negative. So the last element will have minus 1 index value, then minus 2, then minus 3, then minus 4, minus 5, like that. Okay, so indexing can be done in two ways, positive ways and negative ways. If the indexing is done from left to right side, it will be it will start from 0, and if the indexing is done from last to first, then it will start from minus 1, like that. And similarly, while accessing 2D array, again positive and negative indexing is possible. Now see, here we are having two dimensional array, and you can see that this array consists of how many elements? This array consists of 16 elements. So we are having 4 number of rows and 4 number of columns. Now in this case, since this is two dimensional array, we are having two dimension means we are having number of rows and we are having number of columns. So okay bete, let us discuss about positive index and negative index in case of 2D array. So let us talk about first rows. Okay, so this one is row, this one will tell about the rows. Okay, this one is first row, this one is second row, this one is third row, and this one is fourth row. So if you are moving from top to bottom, then you will have positive index. Okay, but if you will move from bottom to top, then you will have negative index. And just now we have discussed that negative index start from minus 1 and positive index starts from 0. So here in case of rows, you can see that if you are going from top to bottom, then the first row will be 0, then 1, then 2, then 3. And if you are moving from the last row towards the first row, then the index value of the last row will be minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. Similarly, let us discuss about the column. Just now we have discussed the same thing, that if we are moving from left to right, then the index of column will be from 0, 1, 2, 3, like that. And if you will move through the column from last column to the first column, then index will start from minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. Okay. So, just let us discuss these things using some programming code. Okay. So, coming back to the code. So, it is suppose I am having one two-dimensional array. Okay. Let us create one two-dimensional array. First, let us have one-dimensional array, then we will have two-dimensional array, and then I will tell you how to access any element from the array. Suppose let us create a one-dimensional array. Okay. So, we are using the array function to create, and to use array function we must have list. Suppose I am having, let us have an array of 16 elements, and I will convert the same one-dimensional array to the two-dimensional array. Okay. So, we are having 16 elements, I think. Okay. Now, let us print what we are getting. So, to print the whole array, just we have to give the name of the array. It will give us the one-dimensional array. See, we are having one-dimensional array. Now, what to do if we want to access a particular element? Suppose I want to print bit 5. Okay. Now, can you tell me what is the index value of 5? Yes. If we will move from the first element, its index will be what? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. So, if I will write print, now how to access any particular element? In that case, beta, you have to write name of the array, and within the square bracket you have to pass the index. In our case, for 5, the index value will be how much? The index value will be 4. Just now we have counted, it will start from 0. Why? Because we are moving from left to right side. So, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, 4. Now, can we access the same element by moving from last to the first element? So, yes, why not? If we want to do that, then the index value of 5 will be what, Betty? Let us count it. If we will move from right side to left side, the index value will start from minus 1. So, this will be minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6, minus 7, minus 8, minus 9, minus 10, minus 11, minus 12. So, the index value will be print A1, then minus 12. So, both the output should be how much, but a 5. Okay, if we are giving the correct index value, the output must be 5 for both of them. Let us run, and yes, we are getting the output 5. So, you must understood that, Bitte, if you are getting positive index, it means we are moving from left direction to the right direction, and if you are getting negative index, it means we are traversing the elements from end to the first. Okay, so the same thing for this one. Let us take another example for 2D array. This one was one dimensional array. Let us convert it into 2D array. So, how to convert, Betty? What was the method? Just now in the previous video, we have discussed that the name of the method is reshape, and what we have to pass? We have to pass the name of the one-dimensional array, and we have to pass how many number of rows and how many number of columns we want. Okay. So, in our case, 4 number of rows and 4 number of columns. Now, let us print array 2. Okay. So, let us see what we are getting. Yes. Here we are having our 2D array. Okay. Now, suppose I want to access the element 2, Betty. How many different ways are there to access the element 2? I think 4 different ways are there. Okay. Let us take the simple way. Okay, we will take the positive index of row and positive index of column. So for that you have to write bete what? Sorry. For that you have to write print name of the array is A2, and if we want the positive index of, since this is two dimensional array bete, we have to tell about the row position and column position as well. Okay, in previous case we were having one dimensional array, so we have to tell about only one index value, that was for row. But in this case we are having two dimensional array, so in this case we have to specify what is the row position and what is the column position. So just see bete, here 2. Okay, so if we will move from this one, this is the first column, this is the second column, but the position will start from 0. Okay, so for 2 the column value will be 0 and 1, and the row value bete, this comes in the first row, and the first row will have index value how much? 0. So can you tell me that for 2 the row position will be how much? Yes, the row position will be 0, and column position will be how much bete? Column position will be 1. Okay, this is the first way. Let us have the second way. Suppose A2, then let us keep the row index as the positive one. Let us have the negative column index. So if we will move from right to left side, then what will be the column index for 2? Yes, it will be -1, -2, and -3. So row position will remain same. Let us keep the row position as positive index value and this one as -3. But at last we will check that whether we are getting 2 for all the 4 written codes or not. Okay, now let us reverse the situation. Let us keep the row position as negative index. So where is 2? Where 2 is in the first row. But if we want to move from last row to the first row, then index will be negative. So in that case row position will be -1, -2, -3, -4. Okay, so in that case the row position will be -4. Let us keep the column as positive index. So column is this one, so column will be 0, 1, so it will be 1. And the last one where, sorry, and the last one where we will take both the negative index for column and row. Can you tell me for negative index of row will be, if we will move from bottom to top, then the index will be negative. So -1, -2, -3, -4. Okay, we will have -4. And what about negative column bete? We have to move from right to left. So 2 is here, so we have to count from here to there. So it will be -1, -2, -3. So -3. So what we are expecting bete? We are expecting that all the 4 codes should give us 2. So let us execute it, and yes, we are getting all the elements as 2. So this was all about bete indexing of array. It is very easy concept and important as well. So hope you all have understood this concept bete. So now this is the time to appear in the test, the review test, that how much you have understood the today's topic. So just go and click on the link given in the description box. And if you find my video useful, then don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Thank you for watching, my dear students. Bye. Take care.